mercy. I thank you for who you are tonight, Lord. And I pray right now, Lord, that you would let the words of my mouth, let the meditations of my heart, Lord, let it be accepted now in thy sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer, in Jesus' name, amen. Praise the name of Jesus. As I stand here tonight, I will be reading from Lamentations, the third chapter, verses 22 and 23. And the subject is, the Lord, he is faithful.
Yes.
I'm going to read the two verses. It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassion fails not. They are new every morning. Great, great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. As a Christian, we should have the attributes of Christ. In Deuteronomy, the seventh chapter, verses 9, understanding therefore that the Lord your God is indeed God.
Yes.
He is the faithful God who keeps his covenant for thousands of generations and constantly love those who love him and obey his commands. Now, why is the Lord faithful? Hebrews 13:8. He is the same yesterday and today forevermore.
Yeah.
Unlike any human leaders, he will never change. If God promises, I said if God promises, Lamentations, the third chapter, verses 23, they are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. As I was studying on he is faithful, I found that it is connecting. I said it's connecting with the word of faith. They cannot be separated, because faith comes by hearing the word of God. If I ask him to heal my body, if I ask him to heal my body, I must have faith that he can, because the Bible says that he is faithful.
Yes.
Faith is not equal to feeling. To allow your feelings to guide your faith is like a truck driver being controlled by the cargo in his truck rather than by the wheels that he is steering.
All
right. It is the wheel, saints, that controls the cargo, not the cargo that controls the wheel. Faith versus feeling. Holy Spirit guidance. Titus 1:15.
Yes.
He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Romans 8:32. Every Christian today experiences tests with regards to money, health, relationships, and more. Will God remain faithful? The answer is yes. God will remain faithful, even when we are not. 2:13 says, if we are faithless, he will remain faithful.
Amen.
He cannot deny himself.
Amen.
Whenever he makes a promise, he keeps it. He's not like us. We can make a promise and we will back up on that promise and we will not do what we said we were going to do. But when he makes a promise, he keeps it. Throughout the Bible, we see God's faithfulness. Just to name a few, God was faithful to Daniel. God's mouth.
Amen.
What about the time when he kept Moses sick as he floated down the Nile's river in a basket? God was faithful.
Yes.
And then he is still faithful today. Now, we're talking about faith. My subject was God was faithful. But we find that you cannot separate those two. They are bound together. We can picture faith as a connection between the work of the Holy Spirit and the power at work in our new nature. What is faith? Faith is a rod that conducts the current that calls grace, that flows from the Spirit. I said faith is a rod that conducts a current called grace, and that